to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, hello! My name is Louise and I do weekly day off vlogs every single Monday, and I've recently moved to Canada from the UK. So if you're going through this process, then make sure you go check out my channel because I've got all the information that you will need over on there. But today I thought I'd do a little sit down video with you. I wrote on my Instagram some ideas for videos. Some of you suggested for me to mention some of my favorite places I have visited since I've moved to Canada. So today I have decided to tell you my top five places that I have found around St. Catharines. So I have ventured a bit further and I have gone to Toronto, but just for this video, I'm just gonna stay nice and local to St. Catharines, Niagara Falls, Niagara-on-the-Lake, etc. And another thing that I'm gonna recommend to you guys is that when you are traveling, try and stay away from the highway and the motorways, because you get to find more and more places. Every time me and Jake go somewhere, we avoid all of the highways and we find new places that we've never heard of before. So that is a little top tip when you're out traveling. So let's get straight on into the video. So I'm not gonna rate them like from 1 to 5. I'm just gonna tell you my top 5 places because I really can't rate them because they're all so different. So I'm gonna start off with number one. Number one is gonna be Ball's Falls for me. So Ball's Falls is like a reservoir. It's got 2 waterfalls. There's one at the top and one at the bottom. The one at the top is a slightly harder hike, but you can get super, super close to the falls. Now, if you don't like hikes, I wouldn't recommend the top one because you can literally see over the whole of the waterfall and you're so, so close. And it was amazing. So me and Jake found Ball's Falls when we were going exploring Lake Ontario. When we got to Lake Ontario, it was a bit foggy, so we thought we would just drive home. And on the way home, we spotted this place. But we did have a picnic box in the back of the car. So what we did is in the car park, we went and sat and had our picnic. And we noticed that lots of cars did this. So if you are going there, there are so many amazing places to sit for picnics. So definitely take a picnic with you. So first of all, we started at the top of the waterfall. We went to the top waterfall first. It was an absolutely beautiful walk there. It was like through the woods. You can take your dogs as well. And it was such a nice little walk. And up the top of the waterfall, there was actually a long wall. And there was a few people sat on there eating their picnics as well. So over the waterfall. And it was absolutely beautiful. But like I do say, if you're scared of heights, don't go to the top because it is kind of scary. And once we went to the top of the waterfall, we walked down slightly and we went down to the bottom of the waterfall, and it was absolutely beautiful down there. It was very well shaded as well, so it was really nice and cool. And then once we'd gone down to the bottom of the waterfall, we noticed that there was an arrow to another waterfall. So there was actually technically 3 waterfalls there, but they all kind of link into one. Now, walking to the second waterfall, I would say it was about a 5-minute walk, if that, but it takes you through a beautiful, beautiful historic like old town, and there are old buildings of a family that used to live there, and none of them have been touched or knocked down. And I'm not really into history that much, but it was honestly gorgeous. It reminded me of like a little village. They had their house there, they had like a woodworker's shop still there, they had a church. It was absolutely beautiful, as you could probably see in the clips, and there were such good photo opportunities as well. So if you're someone like me who likes taking a good Instagram picture, this is definitely a place for you. The little houses are so cute. And then if you just go through the old little town in between the house and the watermill, you will see the fall on the left-hand side. Now, you are able to get to the bottom of the waterfall because there were people swimming in there. We just didn't find out how to do it that day, but we're definitely going to go back and try and work out how to get to the bottom of it, because it was so, so beautiful that we want to go swimming in that waterfall. But my first place on the list obviously is Ball's Falls. We've only been there once and we can't wait to go back. I would say it is like a day out. You could definitely spend the day there because you can go and see all of the waterfalls, you can take a picnic, and normally there's like a little shop open there as well. So yeah, and there are toilets there. They are currently closed at the minute just due to the current situation, but there are normally toilets there as well. But I definitely recommend it. It's called Ball's Falls, and I'm going to link it down in the description box as well. So my second choice on the list is going to be Niagara Falls / Clifton Hill. Now, all of you have probably heard of Niagara Falls before, and you've probably seen it in my vlogs. We go there quite regularly. I think we've been there like 3 or 4 times a month since we've moved here, but it's because it is so beautiful. It's breathtaking, honestly. It's amazing. And obviously you're on the border of New York as well, so you can see New York in the distance, and it just blows me away how close we are to New York. So we have done the trail along the falls. We have walked it, and I would say from the bottom of Niagara Falls all the way to the top is probably about a 20-minute walk. So if you're going out for a walk on one evening and you're in the local area, I would really recommend that walk, because it was really nice. One day we actually took our bikes and we cycled in the opposite direction. So instead of going towards Clifton Hill, we went in the opposite direction where it was a lot quieter, but it was so nice. So we went across a bridge, as you could probably see in the video now. We went across this beautiful big bridge. We went across some ponds and lake where there were swans and little ducks, but it's definitely a lot quieter going that way, and it's just as nice. And I'm gonna upload a picture here, and there's some amazing pictures to get taken down that end, because you can see the whole of Niagara in the background. So you can see the tower and you can see the falls in the background. So I really recommend going the opposite way as well. Next to Niagara Falls as well, there's a place called Clifton Hill. And this, the easiest way I can explain this is if you're from the UK, it really reminds me of Blackpool, like, Strip. So Clifton Hill is obviously on a hill, and it is a very touristy area. So if you're not into touristy areas, this probably isn't the best place to go, but it is still amazing to tick off your list. It's full of bars, it's full of restaurants, it's full of arcades, it's full of like so much good stuff. If you've got kids as well, there's go-karts, there's like a dinosaur world, there's a mini golf, there's like sweet and fudge factories, there's zombie rides, like there's so much going on this one hill. There's also a water park there, a Hard Rock Cafe. Me and Jake actually went for dinner there, I would say last week, and we went to Pizza Pizza. We ate on a patio area and looked over the whole of Clifton Hill. They've also got a Hooters there as well. There's just so much going on, and like I said, it does remind me of Blackpool just because of all the arcades and like the rides that are going on. There's like laser tag. If you're looking for like a Canada merchandise shop, like a souvenir shop, this is where you should go for it. There's this huge Canada souvenir shop that sell like magnets, all the maple syrup sweets, and oh, there's just so much, t-shirts and jumpers. So if you're looking for like postcards and things to take home with you, definitely go try out Clifton Hill, because it's definitely a tourist area. At the top of Clifton Hill, this is where we normally park. You'll find parking there for about $10 for the day, which is just incredible pricing, I think, for such a touristy area. And at the top of Clifton Hill, you can go all the way down to the bottom, and at the bottom you will find Niagara Falls. And also at Niagara Falls, there are so much stuff you can do there. There's the zip wire from the top of the falls down to the bottom. There's also the boat ride as well, and they're both on our bucket list to do. So over the next few vlogs, you'll probably see us do those. Okay, the third thing I'm going to talk about is Niagara on the Lake Outlet Collection Mile. Now, you probably see this in my vlogs a lot. Now, Jake obviously works there, so I go and see him a lot, and I love shopping. So I am there, I would probably say, at least once a week, which is so bad. But it's just so cheap, and I can't explain how cheap it is. If you've seen my vlogs, then you will know. But it's got amazing shops like Calvin Klein, Tommy Hilfiger, Ralph Lauren, Katie Spade, Lululemon, Michael Kors, Nike. Honestly, the shops go on and on. Puma, Adidas, Pandora, and all of these are outlet prices. You're getting all of this stuff for like half the price, and if you sign up to the membership of each store, you also get texts to you to get even more money off. So this morning I received a message from Calvin Klein to give me an extra 20% off the in-store price. So at the minute, a lot of things are 60 to 80% off, and then if I use my code, I get an extra 20% off, which is absolutely bizarre. I recently brought a bag for $528, and when I paid for my UK bank card, it came to £24 with all my discounts, and it was a real leather Calvin Klein bag, and it just blows my mind the amount of money that you save from shopping in the outlets. I recently went in Katie Spade, and they've got the Disney collection there, and there was one of the little card readers, which is normally over $100, and it worked out to be like £14 or something. I'm probably going to go back and buy that because I regret not buying it, but you definitely need to go check out that outlet mall if you're in the local area, because it's absolutely amazing and the prices are insane. Also in the Niagara Outlet Mall, they've also got the beaver tails little hut. So if you want to try beaver tails, then they've got that there. That's obviously one of Canada's like food, like poutine and stuff. I haven't tried it yet, so maybe next time I go, I will vlog me trying it. But every time I go there, I end up eating before and I'm never hungry. But apparently they are incredible. They're like donuts, like long donuts with like toppings that you can choose. They sound amazing. I actually might get one today, because I'm going off out today, so I might try one of those today. They've also got a few food places in there as well, but I would say it's like a day out. You could easily spend a few hours there going in and out of each shop. There's just hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of shops there to look in, and they're all my favorite shops, so I get designer clothes for half the price. The next thing on my list, I don't know how to say this, so I'm gonna apologize if I offend anyone, but Deku Falls, I will write it on the screen so you know how to look it up. But this is actually a really, really nice waterfall. We went here in the winter and obviously in the summer, and it was so good to see the difference between it. So in the summer, all of the fountain had iced over, like, so it was like icelet drops, and it looked absolutely brilliant. Don't get me wrong, it was freezing cold, but it was so good to see it in the snow, and there was nobody there. We were literally the only people there, so it was so good to see it when it's not busy. And we recently went while it was hotter, and it was heaving. It was so, so busy. They've got a little grass area with some seating so you can take a picnic, and at the top there's like an old-fashioned mill, and you can go paddling in the water there, and then there's also a hike down to the waterfall. Now, I wouldn't recommend this hike if you're not, it is a very, very hard hike, and in a way, I don't think that you're technically allowed down in the falls. I just think someone's created this rope to get down there. If you see by the footage that I'm uploading now, it's very, very unsafe. And I've got to say, I was shaking so much, but it was so worth it. So basically, it's just a rope, and you've got to climb down the rope to get to the falls. Getting back up is so, so hard. So yeah, if you're up for a really hard hike, I would definitely recommend that, but please be safe. I don't want to recommend anything that's going to hurt anyone. I do believe if you walk down the actual hike that it takes you on the path, you can get to the waterfalls that way. We're just stupid and we just followed people. I think next time we're going to go down the safer way, because I know there's been about 3 accidents in the last 2 weeks there. So I definitely don't recommend going down the rope. I recommend taking the route that they advise, which is down the path. I am going to warn you as well, in the water there are snakes. Okay, so I don't want to put you guys off, because it is so beautiful down there. There's 2 different falls down there, and it's absolutely beautiful. But when we were paddling, Jake screamed and there was a snake on the water. Now, apparently these are not dangerous snakes. They're just water snakes. And if you get close to it, they'll just go away anyway. They're not gonna go anywhere near you. But I just want to advise and let you know before you get there that there are snakes in the water. But it's definitely worth it, because the pictures you get there are amazing. I'll upload a few on the screen here. You can go right under the waterfall. There were very brave people there that were going right under the waterfall. But as soon as we've seen the snakes, we kind of just stuck to the side. The water is freezing, but it's absolutely beautiful. Even if you don't want to go and do the hike down to the waterfalls, I really recommend the top bit where the mill is, because like I said, there's seating area. There's a place for you to go for a little walk in the water, which is like literally this deep, and it's honestly such a beautiful place, and it's really peaceful there as well. So that is definitely my 4th place on my list. Now, the fifth place and the last place I'm going to tell you about today is going to be Niagara-on-the-Lake in general. Now, Niagara-on-the-Lake is absolutely beautiful. It reminds me of like an English old town. It's very, very old-fashioned. Everything's named after places in the UK, like the Prince William Pub, stuff like that. They've got little boutique shops, like a Christmas shop, a hat shop, a perfume shop. And it's such a nice little walk to go down there, even if you're window shopping. And it's on Niagara-on-the-Lake, which it's a little lake that obviously divides Canada from America, but it's a lot more peaceful and less touristy than Niagara Falls. We've been there a few times now. We don't really go in the shops, we just go for the walk. Also on the drive there, you will go across loads and loads of wineries. Now we haven't had the chance to go in any of the wineries yet because they've only just recently opened, but that is something that's on our list as well. And as soon as we do go to a winery, I'll let you know prices, what it's like. I know they do day trips and stuff like that. So when you're in Niagara-on-the-Lake, I'd recommend you go to Brock Monument. So it's about a 5-minute drive from the bottom of Niagara-on-the-Lake all the way to the top, but there's a monument there. It is a really nice walk to go around it, but the reason I say to go up that way is because there is an amazing viewing point. I'll upload a clip now. So basically you can park up and you're literally right on top of the lake and you're in the middle of America and Canada, and it's such a peaceful, beautiful view and amazing for a photo. So you can see Niagara-on-the-Lake on one side and see America on the other side, and we were just honestly blown away from the view. It was absolutely gorgeous and it was very peaceful up there. And then you can take a nice walk up to the monument. There's a bit of greenery around there, so you can sit and have a picnic there. But honestly, it is so picturesque if you want to go up there. Okay, so that is my 5 favourite places that I have visited so far around the area of St. Catharines. I hope you enjoyed. As you could probably notice, that they're all quite outdoorsy places. Like I said, Canada is known for its beautiful lakes, waterfalls, scenery, and like hikes. And that's one of the reasons why I love it here. But anyway, I wanted to keep this video nice and short and sweet. I hope it was helpful. And if you're ever going to come and visit this side of the country, then I definitely recommend all 5 of those places. But thank you so much for watching. If you're new here, then I would love you to hit subscribe, hit the like button if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you next time. Bye.